or who's going to win?
Radiant Team Bad.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our Star Ladder iLeague Star Series Season 3. The match between Team Royal Gaming Unity vs. FaZe in the Southeast Asia Group Stage Qualifiers. Best of 2, guys, we are currently in game number 2. Remaining. And the score is FaZe 1, Royal Gaming 0. You're here with me, Cyclops, as your caster. That was an awesome game! The first one for FaZe vs. BGU. Again, the same band, Batrider and Putt for Team The Beauty. FaZe's still a slaughter. FaZe's gonna get... this pick band phase is kinda buggy. It's supposed to point on Team FaZe. Point.
5 seconds remaining.
It was totally Team WGU game. They supposed to win that one. There's no way they can lose that game. They got 2 set of racks. They got all tier 3 towers down. They got 2 set of racks. And they lost the game because they kind of tilt. They bought back and died because of the
5 seconds remaining.
On the attempt to take the second racks. And then they got 1 push KO. Man, that's kinda hurt. I'm pretty sure that first game will hurt Team Warrior Gaming morale a lot in this Best of 2 series. Underlord once again and Rubik. While the BGU went for the same heroes, Shadow Demon. It seems like it's all same heroes picked and same hero banned this one. They might pick the same.
10 seconds remaining.
But I think the BUG might go for something like Mirana this one if they can pick it.
Reserve time.
Timbersaw again for Ben.
Radiant
really?
Team Ben.
Who knows, this might be Nana on Timbersaw. Well, talking about Ben Timbersaw last game, I think his farm is still kind of slow. His team fight was okay, you know, standard, but he might have to improve his CS and farming rate. Mirana banned once again. It's all the same ban and pick from both teams. They are going for the same heroes. Mirana banned out. They really don't want Nana to play Mirana. I think Nana is one of the best Mirana in the world right now. If you see him playing ESL 1 Genting, he always win the lane versus all the top mid lane.
5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban.
The Shrek already banned out as well. Seems like FaZe's respect that Lashrak.
5 seconds remaining.
Tinker ban. Nice ban by BGU. The only reason that BGU cannot end the game early with that such a big lead in early game is because Tinker March of the Machine. If last game FaZe's pick something else but Tinker, like if FaZe's got an Invoker or whatever, they're gonna lose the game real quick. Tinker is very good when it comes to defending.
Reserve time.
I gotta inform you guys that after this, we still have one more Best of 2 match, which is Team FaZe's versus Mineski. GG Network. Ogre Magi for FaZe's. Having an Ogre Magi is good for so many carries. You can use Bloodlust to boost them. I don't think it's going to be...
5 seconds remaining.
I don't think it's gonna be Life Sealer, this one for FaZe's. I am thinking
reserve
about
time.
About Juggernaut again. might be a juggernaut by Black. Say hi to all the guys in chat room. Thank you so much for tuning in. Well, let's do something that I haven't done it for a long time. Let's do some hometown shout out. Feel free to type it down where are you watching this game in the world so I can do some hometown shout out for you guys. Ogre Magai, third pick. Waiting for the third pick of Team Warriors Gaming Unity. Maybe position 4 would be great. Second left. A spirit still in the pool. I wonder what Warrior Gaming gonna pick to team up with Chao Demon. Kanka? No. Lina, yeah, hell yeah.
Sand King.
It's gonna be Sand King first as a position 4, I believe.
Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
A sniper for faces. Gonna be sniper
dire
gas.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Meepo!
Oh! Meepo!
Radiant team ban.
My Nana! I didn't expect to see a Meepo in this game out of nowhere. Man. Now this is interesting.
10 seconds remaining.
The last game of the best of 2 series. Gonna end with a Meepo.
5 seconds remaining.
Say hi to all the guys from New Zealand, Iran, Canada, Bangkok, Australia, Seattle, China. Ooh, some Chinese people watching here too. Australia, Zimbabwe, Germany, Antarctica, Netherlands, and Sweden, Malaysia, India, LA, and Poland, Indonesia, Mars, South Africa, Mozambique. And Marina Bay counted as a country.
Dire team ban.
And the San Escobar. What is that? Yeah, the silencer last ban from Team Faces.
10 seconds remaining.
Thank you so much everyone from all around the world for tuning in and supporting our tournament. Feel free to click on follow or better is subscribe so you will not miss any upcoming
remaining
action from us. Star Ladders EN. Juggernaut last ban. Pretty good ban. But it might be a morphling though for faces. Do you think it's gonna be a morphling? But having a morphling with sniper on the same team might be a little too much on farm. But who knows?
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. 5 seconds remaining.
Last second. Went for Slark.
Radiant team pick.
Slark Meeple. Timbersaw. The lineup is kind of weird, but I think the reason that they went for Slug is because they want to fight Sniper in teamfight. Slug is going to go rushing his Child Blade against Silver Edge and try to enter the fight from behind, see where Sniper is, and jump a pulse on him.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Last pick for Team Faces. What's it gonna be? Sniper. Already there. 1 last minute. Still got plenty of time. You can just, you know, slowly think about it. Hello? Oh, okay. Thank you for mentioning about my microphone. I don't know what happened. Just gotta keep on and off. Hello? Test? Cool. Thank you. Thank you very much for mentioning about my microphone. Feel free to type it down if you see any problem or during stream, like audio or overlays, whatever. Thank you so much.
Necroforce.
Very nice. It's gonna be Necroforce as a hard carry, this one. Interesting. They're gonna use a Necroforce to Reaper Sight that Meeple for sure.
Seconds remaining.
Right. We are in the game already. Gonna do some quick intro.
Prepare
play who this one for Team Faces in a red inside. Nuts on Rubik. Black Necroforce. Jabs on Sniper and the Ice on Underlord and X1 Ogre Magi for Team WG and the Dire Side. Afu on Shadow Demon, Ajit on Meeple, X Nowhere on Sand King, Ben Timasaur and Nana on Slark. Surprisingly, it was Ajit as the let's take a look at this one. It was Ajit for Meeple instead of Nana. Nana moved himself to play Slark on top.
30 seconds to battle. Battle begins.
Two Bowery Rune for each team.
Quick bra.
What did he say? Quick bra. Quick bro. Okay, in the middle lane, of course, it's gonna be Jab Sniper versus Ajit as Meeple. The tri lane top is Slark, Sand King by X Nova. And Afu. Bottom lane is solo lane. Ben versus Underlord again. Tri lane top. Let's see. Black went for the first level dead pulse. It's gonna be quite hard for Nana to come in, and you know, especially when Black got his level 2 and he went for the aura, it's gonna be even harder for him. Rubick trying to harass that X-Nova from pulling the creeps. Nice positioning by Team Faces, trying to stop that. Middle lane, nothing much. Oops, they're gonna strike first, pushing the build team. Jumped on Faces, confused. Side out with a disruption. Burrow strike, that was a very nice gank back in the build team. Once again, they have a very good early game, but now you can see how dangerous it is dealing with a disruption and the Burrow strike. Food ready to go in again.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Black trying to use himself as a bait. Not. Two Meepos. Meepos already level 4. Black, even though his team lost the first blood, but he having very good time right here. Level 4 for the sniper. Leading in terms of CS. Nana going in for a nuts. A pulse on him. He's stuck inside. He already used the dark pack. Now awful disruption. That should be another kill.
You never felt more for Nana.
Three and a half minutes. Let's take a look at the graph. Beauty, of course, I hate slightly because of the killings. Black at level 1 of Heartstopper Aura just to scare them. They pulse everything on that Nana, but he's gonna jump away easy. Ignite to slow him down. Black diving in. A little bit too deep if you ask me. Nana using the dark pact.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Tower under attack. Sand King was here trying to pick up some runes. Now he's coming back in with a full HP and full mana. X-Nova ready to drop his burrow strike.
Radiant's middle tower this is
just like a real old school sniper. The fact that he went for a lot of raid ban because he knows that he kind of confident that in late game he will be fat. Having an early raid ban is very good for a sniper. Like he can even go for something like 3 raid ban and later just sell it. This game action pack, not so action pack. This game, KBM is quite low. It's all about the lane control. Seems like Faces having a better lane on top because of this Necro Force. The Dead Pulse and Heartstopper Aura is very good lane control skills. Now finally, they gotta deny the tower. That's the first tower of Team Faces. Now they got some more space to gank on top. As you can see. The BT need to be careful more on their safe lane. Underlord.
Denied.
Shiny.
Shadow Demon and X-Nova. dropping some aggressive of the ward here between the path. Now they saw two supports over there. They might consider it going in for a necro force, light up the disruption, and then the burrow strike. There's not thing much he could do. I'm trying to run away to telekinesis. Oh, another dead pulse comes out, turning from bad to good. But can he get away? No, die because of the chakram anyway. Anyway, he show how hard it is to take him down. Throwing Apple, dropping quite low. He can't run away for the trap now. He's gonna die because of the igniter and his teammate Sue. Only one for one. Back to the top. Quite hard for Nana dealing with that pit lord. It's not Meeple time yet to shine. He still need more items. Let's take a look at his item. He got 1.4k gold in his pocket. Not sure what's his next item. Might be a blink dagger first to start killing people, or maybe just go straight to Dragonlands or an Aghanim Scepter. Now look at the bottom. Next Nova with a Tranquil Boot. He got 400 movement speed ready to charge in. On top, Afu ready to strike. Underlord is here. Archit coming in, trying to gang that Underlord down. He got no Dark Rift yet. If you want to kill him, you gotta kill him now. Open a giant sniper also on smoke.
Dire's middle tower is under
aiming
attack.
For the mid laner. Snowa. Walking away. Using the Dark Rift. Oh, he almost killed a Nana. Slark dropping so low. This is why people ban Underlord, because he's kinda annoying spamming the Firestorm. There's nothing much you could do about that. He would be fat anyway. Let's take a look at the first big teamfight in the middle. Side off with the Barrel's right scene, setting up the Pit of Malaise and dropping quite low. Die because of the Reaper Sider. Enjoy vacation, bro. Assassinate on Apple. Die too on Trapnel. Faces having a very good fight this one, and they're gonna take the mid tier 2 tower. I'm sorry, mid tier 1 2. Archit Meeple. And the Lord. Nats got some space to farm at the bottom. Trying to get his arcane boots up. Seems like faces this game taking down tower so fast. They know that they are much better with an Underlord Firestorm in early game. He maxes Firestorm, he's just gonna keep spam it. Firestorm in early game is ridiculous damage. That's what I'm talking about. Easily clear the creep wave and take the tower. I remember back then in Dota 1 where Underlord Firestorm can deal damage to tower 2. I was like, keep playing this hero, spamming it.
Oh my goodness.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
I missed those times. Dota 1.
Tower is under attack.
Now here we go, telekinesis. Back to the Pit of Malaise. Wow, what a route on 2. Trying to burrow strike away. Ben trying to save his teammate using the chakram to slow him down. Now finally Archit. He's running off his patience. He's trying to come in. And doing some skank finally, going for the support. Archit easily pulls that guy down. Might going in again for X-Nova, ready to do some burrow strike. Here we go.
This will come in handy.
Striking on sniper insane. Everything on a sniper still not level 6 yet for Alpha. No Demonic Purge, so it's gonna take a while to take that sniper down. It's a trade though. 2 for team WG. Might be 3 because Meeple might get caught here. They pose to make him quite low. Reaper of sight. And yes, double kill for standing ice ice ice.
Radiant structures are
fortified. Now Nana got some free space on top. Morgan free farm here for Nana. But he doesn't have that much item yet, because in he got to deal with the Necrophore. So one of the best lane controller in this game with his aura, Heartstopper aura. Is just, I'll take your tribute. Man, I really hate that skills, to be honest. Seven to five game score, only 3 kills away from the first 10 kills.
Mine.
Selfish haste.
The craft now on Team Faces side, and the experience craft is bouncing back to Faces. Nova still this is a second attempt to kill the black, but black now got 1.2k HP already. Started off with the disrupt hunt and a burrow strike. It's too hard to take the black down, to be honest. Oh, a mech already for Underlord. Now just gonna push in for the tier 2 tower. That zoning pit on the list is actually win them a game, I think. There were so many times that they, you know, the pit on the list just locked their enemy down. So easy to play with a pit on the list. Now here we go. Aiming for that Apu burst strike on Apu. Faces got one kill and they might go for more, and for the Reaper dropping quite low. Reaper side, that is why they picked Necroforce for. Oh my. That's what I'm talking about. Back to the top, Nana. A pounce on that black, but I don't think he's strong enough to take down that black. Black is gonna chase on him. Dead halt. This work. Oops. I'm sorry, my mouse is hanged. I can't move the camera right now. Now the next thing I know when I come back is Dead Lord. I'm sorry, Underlord finally goes down, and it's 2 kills for Team WG. Nice right back this one. Don't give up too easy, WG. The game is still too long. 9-7 game score. WG. Surprisingly, Meepo got the highest net worth. Despite the bad early game of Team WG. Well, we'll see. He might. He's on his way to his next Dragonlance. Already got a Blink Dagger. Let's take a look at this one. Hit the Malise. Darkrai comes out. Whirling Day. Burrow Strike on Rubik. Another kill for Team WG. 9-8 game kill. We still don't know who's gonna get the first 10 kills. Faces was 9 for so long already. WG is catching up. Arctic Soul Erosion.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Sniper shooting on a Nana. Nana not so close. Not even close to his shell blade. One on the bottom. What happened right here is Underlord 1v2, another Reaper side to kill that X-Nova. However, some good news for the WG supporters, they just got an Aegis. But Faces is gonna take down that bottom tier 2 tower. And it is a tower for Black. Black went for a Reaver to discourse. Take a look at his talent tree. He went for plus 40 damage instead of a tanky style. Plus 6 strength. Now he got 1.2k HP. This next one should be, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be plus 6 stats. The talent tree of Necroforce is quite weird.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Plus 10% magic resistance. 10 to 8 gain score. Meeple Vinan Aegis.
Dire's middle tower is
just
under
need
attack.
To blink dagger in.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
A stun on the Timisaur. Timisaur, nothing much yet. Die because of the assassinate. However, Nana piles in, aiming for the black, dropping quite low. Already he popped the pulse. The dead pulse comes out, and here comes the epicenter burrow strike. Tons of damage. Now it's time to come back for Team WG. But when they are about to get another kill, the Dark Rift just save all of them. Sniper paused the game. 11 to 10. Going more for XY. That was really close. XY.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle
Shadow
tower
Blades already for Slot. Now, like I mentioned earlier, the only reason that they pick Slark as their last pick is they really want to fight a sniper in team fight. They only got one job, to fight a sniper.
Radiant's bottom tower
Shadow Blade, maybe Silver Edge. Might need Blink Dagger too, and that's another kill on Nice Eye Sights. 11 to 11. It seems like lately, in the past 5 minutes, Phasers got caught so many times alone. Now look at that, it's gonna be another kill by Nana, but Telekinesis is quite fast reaction time by Nana, but it's just not fast enough to save his life. Running away with this pro just hit the Nana. They better be careful because every time that they get Reaper side down, it's gonna add some extra time into respawn to them, and they're gonna waste a lot of time for that.
Radiant structures.
Not sure what is this next item gonna be. It seems like he went for a blink dagger. Do we need an Aghanim scepter, or maybe just goes for something bigger like Jewel Scars or all those stuff? But they almost get a tower. Ben is trying to use himself as a tank to blink in burrow strike on 3, but he can't fight a sniper yet. Reaper side finally comes out. We wasn't able to kill Ben, but his teammate follow up, and Ben finally goes down, piles away, being chased by that black. Assassinate and die because of the aura, I think. That's how he laughs, actually. I don't think they are laughing right now because that game looking pretty bad for Team WG. But they actually ahead. Even though Team Faces won a team fight, but WG is still ahead in terms of experience and gold. Sanking is on his way to a 4 star.
Illusion.
The blink dagger. Another whole team smoke, but Team Faces trying to entering. Underlord is right here. Try to find where's the Meeple. Meeple got 2 Dragonlands already for Ajit. A lot of stats. Plus damage and plus 15% lifesteal. Meeple against the world. A whole team of Team Faces are here ready to drop a Reaper Sight. Didn't even need it.
I'll take that.
And he died just now. Level 18. Next one should be plus 25 attack speed for Meeple. Getting ready for Eye of Skadi. Alright, I'm gonna show you guys some items update. Seems side faces just want to take all the out powers of team WG, but WG this time is not going to give up that easily. Coming in fast by Nana, ready to use his shell blade, finding some sniper inside. That's the one talking about, he entering from the back line. He saw that nut going in or not, aiming the nut instead of sniper. Sniper is just gonna shoot him. They get that Rubik first. No more, no fail. It's time to crack them all down. The sniper gonna be the next one. Epic center barrel strike comes out. There's no chance for Underlord to use his dark pack. They all die. Fall down for team faces. That's what I'm talking about. That is just a, like, you know, right out of textbook. The way they should attack, they did it all correct for team WG. Strike team faces from behind, fighting that Rubik or sniper first. Once Rubik or sniper goes out, the rage is jumped in with a lot of maples. Perfect team fight. And Ajit, where is he? Killing so fast. Ogre Magi, the only survivor from just now team fight, died right after because of the Ajit. Ajit's on his way to an Eye of Skadi. Silver Ledge and 820 gold. Seems like Hame of Dominator is becoming a trend in Dota world right now. Everyone seems to go for it. Black. House on the black. Maybe Demonic Purse would be great. But Pick of Elise comes out. Can they kill the black? The black trying to stay alive in the dead holes. Rooted? Nah, he gotta go away. Bomb lane pushing in by the BG Ben.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Just wait until that Meeple get the Eye of Skadi. No, actually Meeple just gonna go for a Mantis style. Meeple Manta.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Ben on the bottom lane, his farming rate is quite much better than last game. I remember last game he get Bloodstone on 25 minutes. That was quite slow. Yeah, her performance, his performance is getting better in the second game of the series. Once again, the BG trying to strike on top, but I don't think FaZe is gonna make the same mistake, and that's why not placing them off the rewards. It's not a very important spot, it's just for this team fight. Now Dark Rift to the middle lane. Virgin knows about that and they retreated. It seems like my internet connection is not just now wasn't so stable. Now it's getting better, so it should be fine now. Nana. No. 17-14 game scores. Game to be seems to be a long game again, guys. As both teams don't want to make any mistake in this such a. I think in 7.01 patch, after 30 minutes, is considered a late game already. Nice dodging the damage of this assassinated by using a disruption. The disruption will be the key in this team fight for sure. Whether he uses it in attack or defense. Sand King on his 4 star. Let me adjust the... Let me adjust the this one a bit.
Invisibility.
Alright, should be fine now. To 17 game, so they are back to the farming phase. Especially for Slark, he's need a lot more items. What about Sniper? Sniper, oh, might get caught by Sand King. Sand King is trying to calculate his damage, but he knows that it's not enough. We are entering late game, guys. Is right here trying to farm. Let me adjust the stream a bit so you can have a smoother stream. Sand King throws right in. Yeah, the stream should be fine by now. I just lowering the bit rate a bit. Back in the middle lane.
Regeneration.
Nothing much going on for now, it's just, you know, but the thing is the beauty already got his Aegis and moving forward to the mid tier 1. They might have to take down the tier 2 first in order to take down on the shrine. I don't think they should just rush straight to the tier 1 mid.
I'll take your tribute.
This is just like the last game, that Team The Beauty trying to control Team Faces, trying to force them to play a turtle strat, as you can see. But that's a lot of sentry here around the map. I'm sorry, around that base.
Radiant's top tower is under
first
attack.
Reason that they want to sentry is to cover them from the Slark, and also to see if Team The Beauty want to play some attacking observer wards on them. But a strike on Sand King. Down a shrine, 14 to 18 game score. The game becoming so quiet, like for like 5 minutes already. It's all about the map control at the moment. The beauty doesn't have any vision left, while Faces got two observer wards outside, some of the sentry wards. Just make sure that they don't make the same mistake like last game, they'll be fine for the BG. the fact that they control the map right now makes them got a lot of experience and the gold advantage. This is the item update once again. On his way to Eye of Skadi for that meeple. He went for Etheroblade first. And Eye of Skadi. And then the Mantis style. Bar on the high ground. That was really close. The thing is, Faces always got some heroes that is very strong when it comes to high ground defense. Last game they got a Tinker, this game they got a Sniper. Now they know the Sniper doesn't have a Black King bar, so they might try that chance here. Going in without an ace is quite risky, but they got two Snipers coming in quite deep, Sniper dropping quite low, Darkrai not gonna help, he was taking too long. Sniper fought back right away. Now it's time for Nana to retreat, but he might. Oh, look at that! Wow, disruption to dodge the damage of the Reaper side. What a play by Apple. Saving Archit over there. Triple kill for Archit, cleaning every. Oh, it's a GG call right away, Faceless. What a play by Team WG, only one attempt to high ground, they won the game. Best of two series, end with a tie, guys. You're gonna take a break for a few minutes, and the next match is going to be Team Faces versus Mineski GT Network. Big match coming up. Stay tuned.